Welcome back to Let's Play A Tear of Vermillion Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're here in Theta. We're supposed to deliver a letter from the Baron. That's Eimelle. I heard that there is a splendid grand cathedral in the Holy Capital Vault. I'm a little excited to see it. Very excited. Right, so we arrived here and really haven't looked around at all, so... Mile says, by the way, there are many soldiers at the pier. Why don't we give the letter from Baron to one of them? I guess. I mean... I was supposed to give it to somebody... in particular. To the army commander. No, we have to go to the army commander. Merchant Garcia says, was this the guy from the other place who was a jerk? It's a rural area here compared to Beloa. There are no monster carts available to put products in. Since there is no adventurer guild here either, I was going to hire an adventurer who was on the same boat as I was. But he refused because he said he had some previous engagement. He said he had to escort an old man with his granddaughter. How come adventurers are so not flexible? He rejected me even though I offered to pay 3 times more than usual. All I have to do is wait for another adventurer to come. But the menu of the restaurant makes me anxious. Anxious? What, to eat? Oh. How do I get over here? You must be tired from a long journey. Are you here to visit the Holy Capital? Avin says, you are right about us going to Valkt, but not to pay a visit. I see. There are monsters appearing on the Holy Capital Highway recently. Looks like you're with a girl, so please be careful. Avin says, I'm glad we can arrange a monster cart. Are you looking for a captain of the King's Army? I think he should be at the bar for sailors. So there's another bar for sailors. Hello, welcome, Rizette says. Today's menu is fresh bitter melon salad, spicy octopus and squid, and caramel mousse for dessert. All that sounds good to me. Enjoy harmony of bitterness, spiciness, and sweetness. Avin says, looks like they have a harmful effect when eaten together. If I go from here... No, she says the same thing. I like to talk to them behind the counter because I like them to complain. When, like, you must go on the other side of the counter. Alright, so there's nothing here. Back room. But there are stairs going up here. Probably a place to rest. Do we need rest? No, we don't. We have a little more work to do. 100 roses, getting more expensive. Wah, wah. South Vault. South is Vault. Oh, really? Vault isn't right down there, right? Look around. Nothing back here? Greetings. Baruch says, there is the King's Army stationed in this town, but we can count the number of the soldiers with one hand. Besides, they are all new ones, so they are unreliable. But if there's an emergency, it's comforting to know that the Paladin Army in Valkt will come. The Paladin Army, huh? That goes off the screen. Alright. Let's look around on this screen before we move anywhere else. I can't get behind the counter. Welcome! We have convenient goods here. Well, I'm gonna do the exchange. Probably not gonna buy anything. Tempted to buy some rarer potions. You used a lot of them. But maybe the cat will find some. A circle charm. Talisman containing oxide circle inside gives neutral damage to an enemy. Huh. What's neutral damage? Talisman containing flare ghost inside gives fire damage over a limited area. Quake charm containing death quake gives earth damage to the surrounding. Oh, he does sell some of this stuff. Unfortunately, Avin is the only one present, so I can't really compare. Behind the counter! Hey, don't enter here! Come around to the front of the counter! I like that. Welcome! Ask me anything about the weapons and protective gear. I don't want to ask you anything. Alright, so he has the claymore. Valditz. Is there someone else? Spin saucer. Wow, nothing really. It's all the same stuff we've seen. See you then. Not if I see you first. West is dorks. They're a bunch of dorks. Well, let's go this way. Is it really all connected? I don't know. Alright, we'll look around here. The voice of a girl says, "Are you ready?" A boy's voice says, "Not yet." Oops! Ouch! Says Avin. Hunt says, "Sorry." Girl's saying, "Are you ready?" Oops, says Hunt. "Not yet." They're playing tag or something. Avin says, "So young." Amy says, "Where are you? I can't find you at all. I'm right in front of you." She's gonna find us. Don't talk to me. I talk to you more. Interesting. Oh, is this the Sailor's Bar? Sailor Alno says, "Do you know the Planetos? It's the fastest sailing ship around the neighboring sea. Using the port of Brzak as a base, it can go through Canafia, Boren, Beloa, and Theta in a little over 2 weeks. Its speed is unbelievable." Unbelievable, I tell you. Master says, "This is a bar for the sailors and soldiers. High-class customers should go to the inn." Avin says, "I'm looking for a captain in the king's army. Do you have any idea where one would meet?" Are you looking for Captain Malian? I think he's training his men at the pier. Captain Malian should be training at the pier. Okay. What pier? Oh, this looks like a lighthouse. Like the other lighthouse. Oh. Can't even try to get in there. Like, the setup of this is weird, I don't know. Well, that just ends there. Is this the pier? Hello? Lasaria says, you must be the one who came by the Planetos. How may I help you? I'm looking for a captain of the King's army. Do you know where he might be? You must be talking about Captain Malian. I think he's training his men at the pier ahead. Okay. Probably further this way. I just want to look around now. Oh. Sailor Bohm says, was I dreaming or something? I came to Theta by ferry boat the other day. I heard a voice from the cargo room during the trip, so I peeked in because a stowaway might have been hiding in there. Then all of a sudden my body immobilized and started to get dazed. I fell asleep like that in a pile of stuff. Because of that, I was scolded by the captain. Was I that tired? I don't think so. I have no idea what to tell you. Alright. Is this the same guy? Wait. This is someone else, right? Yeah. Sailor Kelji? Kelj? Says, I heard that the Siam Seal Gang appeared at the port of Paloa. They failed to abduct a girl. I wonder why they wanted to abduct the girl. Was she rich or something? Not exactly. It's something a little more mystical in nature. Oh, wow. Well, I guess they're down here. Oh, come over here. I don't need that. Find rarer potion. Ah! That must be him. Oh. Find rarer potions, I said. Cadet Rabio says, huh! Wow! I'll never fail to meet Captain's expectations. Oops. Cadet Todd is breathing hard. I'm starving. Hi. You need more guts. Fight. You shouldn't handle a spear only with your arm. You handle it by swinging it from your hip. Excuse me, says Avin. What do you want? By any chance, did any monsters appear on Holy Capital Highway? Those wicked monsters. They are cowards if they try to attack us when we are training. Avin says, no, it's not that. I was entrusted with a letter for you. Avin handed Baron's note to him. This is from Baron Conrad. Baron Conrad's been good to me, so I'll be happy to help you. Cadet Todd, Cadet Rabio. I think there was a monster card on reserve. Is it tuned up and ready to go? No, the wheels are not fixed yet, Rabio says. Captain says, I will show you how to fix them. It may take a while, so please wait for me at the inn. Guys, come follow me. Rabio says, yes, sir. Todd says, aye, sir. Okay. Avin says, it looks like it's going to take a while. Well, I guess it's alright. I better get back to Eimelle and Mile. Sounds like a plan. It's lively as usual. It doesn't look like it, but being captain is a tough job. He's managing this troop with a small budget and a number of people. Eimelle says, I hope I didn't take him too much time to arrange a monster cart. Next time I see Muse, I'd better suggest to increase the budget. Okay. Does people have anything different to say? Let me off. I saw the captain running toward the town in alarm. He usually looks bored, so it was a rare thing to see him like that. Alarm? Because we want the monster part? The young girl says, you finally came this far. Can't be the ones playing hide and seek. Oh, who's that over there? Rutis? Says Avin. What are you doing here? I heard you were reunited with your sister. You must be happy. But you are off your guard. What else would I be here for? The sacred treasures, of course. Uh-oh. Avin says, you haven't given up yet, huh? Just leave the Octum's apostles. Return to Ruka and live with him for his sake. Don't even mention his name. I'm not going to be so merciful this time. We have our backs to the wall after making too many mistakes. We? Says Avin. Don't forget about me, a vulgar voice says. Who are you? Bernard says, we met at the Sage's Mansion. Have you already forgot the power of my axe? Oh yeah, I remember. You call that power? You really sucked. What? Bernard, don't let him get to you. By the way, I heard about the incident in Beloa. Losing the Siam Seal gang hurt us. Avin says, so you are all behind it. What do you want from Eimelle? Bernard says, worry about yourself before you worry about your sister. Rutis, I'll beat him like a drum. Oops. Avin says, humph, I don't have time for you. Amy says, what's going on? Go away, says Avin. It's too dangerous here. She's gonna mess things up. Amy's yelling, no. Bernard says, damn it. How has this brat improved so fast? People get stronger when they have something to protect, says Avin. Don't even think you can beat me now. Hunt says, wah! Shoot, it's that boy, says Avin. He's gonna hold him hostage. Hunt's yelling, ah! Ah ha ha! Now I have the upper hand. Throw away your sword, now! Rutis says, Bernard, don't involve an innocent child. Hehehehe, I can't hear you. Sheathe your sword and turn around. If you don't listen to me, this child will die. Alright, says Avin. Gah ha ha, he really sheathed his sword. Is he crazy? Avin, says Rutis. Avin says, the sacred treasures are very important, but they're not worth a child's life. Take it and leave. Bernard says, your calm attitude makes me sick. Whoa. What the? Says Rutis. Hehehe, he's out cold. Bernard, stop that. He's dragging him out. Rutus, what are you doing? We still haven't got Cabeza. You are under my command. I won't let you do anything to dishonor the name of Octum. Don't be so generous. The girl's voice yells, hurry, come this way. Damn it, we were this close, says Bernard. You traitor. You are neither my boss nor my friend. You're just a halfwit who has no right to talk about Octum. Bernard saying all that, huh? Rutus says, I was... Eimelle says, you are... Mile says, you are Rutus? Your friend is in the storehouse. He's unconscious because due to his injury. Treat him as soon as possible. Avin! Yells Eimelle. Mile says, wait, what are you going to do now, Rutus? Ruka was very worried about you. I have no place to go anymore. I can't go to Ruka or to my master. Avin, are you all right? Says Eimelle. That kid's still in there, too. Avin. Mile also says Avin. Avin's coming too, I guess. Avin! You're up! Where am I? Mile says, you're in the room next to the inn. Oh, that back room. Soldiers helped me carry you there. Captain Malian says, I'm sorry I was late. Even though it's my duty to maintain public peace at Theta, I let those bastards enter here in broad daylight. Those bastards, said Avin. Oh no! My Cabeza and Kuropo, they must have... Avin looked inside his inner pocket. Phew, I've got both of them. I remember I got beaten up by that spiky-haired dude. Mile says, it looked like they had a fight. I think Rutus stopped the other guy. Eimelle says, that girl with the black hair, she looks sad. Yeah. Ouch, says Avin. Mile says, you might was to lay down. Okay. Eimelle treated your injury, but your wounds haven't healed yet. Oh, you treated me, says Avin. Thanks, Eimelle. Don't worry about it, but you have to stay in bed for a while. The captain says, I've already arranged a monster cart for you, but it looks like you should reschedule it. That's all right, says Avin. We will take off soon. Avin, says Mile. I don't think that spiky-haired dude would give up. We better head for the Holy Capital before he attacks us again. You're right about that, says Mile. It may be better if we leave now. Avin, says Eimelle. I have a bad feeling. We're going to be fine, Eimelle, says Avin. I promised you I'd protect you. Oh, wow. What about the other areas we haven't gone to? Avin says, this is the first time I've ridden on a monster cart. It's very comfortable. It's my first time, too, says Mile. I feel like I'm rich. How about you, Eimelle, says Avin. Do you like it? It's very comfortable, but... Does your back hurt? No. It's just that riding on this, I can't help remembering... Right, how they left the cathedral at the beginning of the game, and that Avin got left behind. The day I was taken away from you. Right, says Avin. I didn't ride the monster cart then. Mile says, come on, don't think about that. You guys are together now. Forget about those sad times. Tons of happy things are waiting for you. This monster cart will surely be a good memory about this journey. Oh my god, so much dodgy dialogue here. Avin says, Mile. Eimelle says, Mile, thank you. Haha, don't thank me. Avin says, well, I haven't really shown my appreciation, so thank you for sticking with me all this time. Who are you and what have you done with Avin? Says Mile. I'm serious. I couldn't have come this far alone. Without you, I would have never found Eimelle. Your white spells always help me. Your wits got us out of tight situations. You encouraged me. Then, sometimes when I needed it, you scolded me. I really appreciate everything you've done for me. Hey, Avin, you sound like we're never going to see each other again. Avin says, we're arriving at Valk soon. I just wanted to say thank you before we get there. I didn't do much. By the way, it may well be this bell that saved you, Avin. Wow, says Eimelle. It's a beautiful sound. Mile says, this is a guardian bell. My father gave it to me. He protects people who are important to the person who carries it. Or it protects people. It's a very pretty bell, says Eimelle. Avin says, hey, I wonder how your parents are doing. They're probably living a carefree life as always. I must also thank you, Avin. Because you took me with you, I was able to see the vast land of Elfilden. I saw many places, ate many things, and made many friends. I couldn't have experienced all that staying in the village. Besides, I got to meet a very cute girl, too. Eimelle's chuckling, Mile. Avin says, I also met a cute girl. You remember Shannon, don't you? Oh, please. She's cute, but... Did you hear that, Eimelle? Yells Avin. Eimelle says, yes, I did. I'd love to meet her. Avin says, we may will probably see her again soon. She may chase us all the way to Valkt. Give me a break, says Mile. Avin! Yells a girl's voice. Her ears ringing? Or is that... Rutis? Avon's yelling, whoa, whoa! It is Rutis. You don't just run out in front of a monster cart like that. That's dangerous, says Avin. Don't worry about me. I came here to tell you to... not to go any further. Go back to Theta at once. Go back? Says Avin. We're already halfway through the highway. Why should we turn back now? You became too popular in Beloa. You attracted his attention. He can easily catch you by putting his guys along this highway. Who's he? Mile says, you mean they're waiting for us ahead? Yes, so... A vulgar voice says, ooh ha ha ha, I found you. Avin yells, what's that? Eimelle says, brother, another monster cart is approach us from behind. Rutis yells, it's Bernard. Why are you here? Rutis, I'm disappointed in you, says Avin. You tricked us. You stopped our monster cart so we would be caught. No, that wasn't my intention. Ooh ha ha ha. This time the secret treasure and the girl are mine. Damn, says Avin. Avin yells, Mile, Eimelle, hang on tight. We'll hurry to Valkt. No, don't go there, says Rutis. Get out of the monster cart and run to Theta. Shut up, says Avin. So there's danger from behind and ahead? You fools. You think a monster cart carrying three people can run faster than mine? I can see it's your first time on a cart. Let's see how you keep up with my technique, or something like that. Come on, kids, fight back. Damn, the wheels are shaking, says Avin. Miles yelling, Avin. Eimelle yells, brother, ooah! Avin says. Woohoo, I got them. Ha ha ha, I finally did it. I got the girl and the sacred treasure. Now I can have tons of roses and any position I want. Do you think so? Says the eerie voice. It's, what's his name? The guy from the beginning? Yeah. Bellius. Master Bellius? You must belong to Octum's apostles, Lord Bellius says. What's your name? My name is Bernard. I report to Rutis, but she betrayed Octum's apostles. That's why I captured the girl and got the sacred treasure. Thank you. I'll reward you greatly. It was my pleasure. What will it be? Roses or a top position in management? Haha, it's much better. He's gonna kill him. He, says Bernard. Wah! You idiot. You messed up our plan. How can you resort to such violent measures? What if Durga's daughter had died? You don't want to make the same mistake we made 15 years ago. Please wait, says Rutis. Bernard! Rutis, help me! I don't want to die! I don't want to die! Ah, says Rutis. Will you vaporize the guy? Master Bellius, why did you have to kill Bernard? He doesn't deserve to be an Octum's apostle. I can't believe our great organization accepted such an inferior man, a member. We must review our selection criteria. Avin says, "Oh." Hey, you! I remember you. You were the one who robbed Cathedral 8 years ago. So that was 8 years ago. What was he saying about the same mistake we made 15 years ago? Oh, you're that kid. Wrong, you're. I see you're all grown up. Shut up, says Avin. I won't let you touch Eimelle. I spared your life back then. I won't bestow that kindness twice. I'll take good care of your sister. If I were you, I'd give her up. Rutis says, run! You can't take him on. Everyone, take Durga's daughter. I won't let you, says Avin. He can't run, he'll be leaving him out. Rutis yells, stop! Rutis, what are you doing? Says Bellius. I don't mean to betray you, but I think this is wrong. How could you kill Bernard? He wasn't a good person, but he didn't deserve death. My brother, did you really order Borgied to... Yes, I ordered Borgied to kill your brother, right in front of your eyes. I had to sever the emotional ties with your family in order to make you to become a better apostle. Rutis says, you're so merciless, Master Bellius. Avin says, Rutis, don't you understand? It's stupid to work for them. Ah, says Rutis. Oh, they're teleporting around. Avin, yells Rutis. Wah! Rutis? Damn, she's one of your own. Oops. Ugh. Rutis, I know your passion and dedication. You were born to become an apostle. You may be confused now, but you'll come back to me sooner or later. Durga's daughter. You have the same divine aura I felt from that girl 15 years ago. What? What girl? She has already met with Durga. Now our plan is in the final stage. Oh, yells Mile. Miles waking up. I won't let you touch Eimelle. Well, well, you have great passion, young man. But what can you do? You're wounded. Again, yours. Wrong, your. I promise my father, I'll save the people I love with my life. They're finally together. I can't let you tear them apart again. That's a shame. Oh, is that his blood? Oh my god. Ugh. Oh my god, he's bleeding to death. I think I've done enough. You have strength, but there is no way you'll survive this. You're talking to someone who's unconscious? A powerful voice yells, everyone, quick! Well, well, well. I've been waiting for you. One of the other Yeah, they are sages. Sage of power, feel the same sorrow you felt 8 years ago. We teleported them away. He teleported Mile as well. Sage Gawain says, I have a bad premonition. Oh no, I was too late again. We'll call you Sage the Late. The happy journey ended in disaster. Lord Belius, the head of Octum's apostles, occupied Cathedral 8 years ago. His sinister hands took the people Avin cared about to a place no one knows. Avin doesn't know that terrible tragedy has befell upon him. Great despair will fill his heart. Ugh, says Avin. Am I dreaming? Where am I? Mile? Eimelle? What's going on? Wow. Well, he teleported Mile with him. I don't know what the whole deal was with that. Why, he took Mile as well. But Mile, hopefully, is not dead. He lost a lot of blood, it seems. Yeah, a little worried about that. Anyway, stay tuned for next episode, guys. We're gonna see where the hell we are. I guess maybe we've been taken back to Cathedral. I'm not sure. At least we have our kitty with us. Eimelle taken again. I don't need that. Find some rarer potions. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.